Hello, this is David Briggs speaking to you from New York City and the Cathedral of St. John the Divine, and sending you my very best wishes and hoping that you're managing to stay clear of this terrible COVID-19 virus. I thought you might be amused to see my new mask. Here it is. Paris, France. And you can see there the Notre Dame and the Tour Eiffel, and a bicyclette, and even a baguette, and a nice glass of wine. So I get some nice compliments from that, especially riding the subway here in New York City. So today I'd like to warmly propose to you this performance of the finale from Alexandre Guilmant's Sonata No. 1 for organ. Guilmant composed this piece in 1875, and later rescored it actually for organ and full orchestra, and call it his première symphonie. There's a very interesting lineage from Alexandre Guilmant, which stretches back right to Johann Sebastian Bach. Guilmant studied in Belgium with Nicolas Jacques Lemmens, and Lemmens was himself a pupil of Adolf Hess, who was a pupil of Christian Rinck, who was a pupil of Johann Christian Kittel, who was a favorite pupil of Johann Sebastian Bach. Alexandre Guilmant was appointed to La Trinité in Paris, a great cavaillical organ, in 1871, and remained there for nearly 30 years. And he was very much beloved as a teacher. In 1894, Guilmant, with Charles Bord and Vincent Dandy, founded the Schola Cantorum. He was really one of the very first organists to make a huge name for himself in the United States. The French tradition started really with Guilmant, and he gave many recitals here, including famously on the organ at the St. Louis Exposition, which later became the world-famous organ in the Wanamaker store in Philadelphia. So here is this fabulous piece, the finale from Guilmant 1. And I was talking to my fellow artist in residence, good friend Paul Winter, the marvelous jazz musician and great saxophonist, yesterday. And we were talking about organ music and the way that it can really overwhelm your spirit. And once it's got into the bloodstream, it's just the most wonderful experience and the most wonderful sound. And I suppose one of my great desires, not only during the pandemic, but in a much broader sense, is to introduce people who have not had this experience. As Paul described it, it's overwhelming, but not in an aggressive way, in a very supportive and nourishing way. And I think you can really hear this very clearly in this fantastic piece of Guilmant. So as my very much missed and great friend John Scott used to say, this is a real stonker, a very nice piece of British terminology, and I hope very much you'll enjoy it.